In this tutorial, we will be adding a free wishlist to your WooCommerce website within 10 minutes. It's completely free and very easy to implement. If you want to help me out, and I will be forever grateful, go to wp.discount/wishlist. This link is also in the description of this video and in the comments, so feel free to use that one. And then we are at the website of Yit. Now, Yit is a company that creates a lot of WooCommerce plugins and add-ons, and they do it quite well. Now, for this plugin, we're going to use the free version. So we go over here and press on this button, get the free version. And then the free version starts downloading, and now we have it on our PC. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP Admin, a very safe way, so make sure to secure your web shop, and it's a high target for hackers. On the dashboard, we go to Plugins, Add New Plugin. Then click on Upload Plugin, and we're going to select the plugin we've just downloaded. And press Install Now. And then we press on Activate Plugin. Then on the left side, go to Yit Wishlist. For this plugin, we actually only have 3 pages of settings, and I will walk you through all 3 of them so we can set this up on our Elementor e-commerce website. On the general settings, the first thing we need to enable is the Ajax loading. Enable this. Why? If you have a caching plugin, and I really think you should have one, then it will bypass it so that it will always work. Really great. Then we press on Save Options, and we go over here to Add to Wishlist. Then we are at the general settings about the Add to Wishlist button. As after someone has pressed the button Add to Wishlist, what will be shown? The Add to Wishlist button again, the View Wishlist button, or the Remove from List link? I would go with the third one, as it's way logical. When you're on a product, you add it to the wishlist, and then you can remove it again from there. Then we scroll down. Here we are at the loop settings. By default, this plugin will add in the wishlist button to individual product pages, category pages, archive pages, sliders, everywhere on your website. Well, we actually don't want this if you have Elementor, because then we can add them in our theme builder by hand and it will work way better. So we're going to disable this one. If you don't use Elementor on your e-commerce website, you can choose the position over here on top of the image, before the add to cart, after, or a shortcode, so you can still add it in manually on your pages. In our case, we're just going to disable the loop function because we don't need it. And then the next setting is about the individual product pages. Where do you want to have the wishlist button? After the thumbnails, the add to cart button, the summary, the shortcode. If you have Elementor again, just keep it on this, it is fine. Then we can change all the text. Add to wishlist, if you want to change it, product added, browse it, or already in your wishlist, just change it in here. Then we have the style and color customization. Well, there are actually 3 styles we can use within this free plugin. We have the textual one, the button with theme style, and a button with custom styles. Before I can demonstrate it to you, let's first add it in our website so you can see what the difference is. Press Save Options. Then we go over here to Templates, to the Theme Builder. And on the Theme Builder, we can go to the Single Product and press on Edit. In here, we're going to add in a new widget. Search for the Yit widget called Wish. And then we just drag and drop this Yit Wishlist Add button to anywhere you want on your product page. I wanted to go over here below the customer reviews. Then on the left side, we can customize it just a little bit. The product ID, you don't want to change this because this is the template, so it will be automatically done the way it should be. Here you can change again the text labels. Again, don't do this in here, but do it just in the settings of the plugin so you always know where you have changed it. And of course, you can go to Advanced to change, for example, the icon of the button. Then we go to Advanced, and I want to change the margin just a little bit. So unlink it, and on the top, minus 15, and on the bottom also minus 15, because this is just way better in my design, as you will see. Press Update, then I open up my website in private window, and here we are. We have the dump watch, and in here we have this one, Add to Wishlist. It is here, but it's a little bit light, so we need to style this text, of course. Let's first go with the button with theme style. Then we have just a purple button from WooCommerce, and it looks like this when you have edited in. But we can also use the custom style, save it, and then the custom styles looks way better with our design. And then when we press the add to wishlist button, I go over here the standard WooCommerce purple color. So if you want to change this, we need to change the standard WooCommerce colors. But in this case, I'm going to show you how to do it with CSS, so we don't need to have this one. Now you know all these styles, but we're going to use the textual color and we're going to change it with some custom CSS. We're just going to do this inside of Elementor, so we don't need it over there. And the next thing is to change the icons. We can change the open heart, and this one is a closed heart when you've already added it to your wishlist. Of course, you can change it here. We can also use a star open and a star closed, whatever you want for your website. All right, press save options. And then we go over here to the wishlist page. Click on it. Now this plugin automatically created a wishlist page for us to see. If you go to pages, all pages, you can see over here that there's a wishlist page. And when you view it, you will see that it's just the wishlist with my wishlist. And there is the table created by the plugin. Great. But you might not want to have my wishlist because it is actually double. We're going to fix this later on in these settings. So scroll down. You can also create your own page. Just use this shortcode. Edit in your page and you're good to go. All right, then we have the detail page. In the table, you can customize different things that are being shown inside of this wishlist table. You can also use product variations, the date on which it has been added, the price, the stock, add to cart option for each product. Very useful. And then we have an icon to remove the product entirely from the wishlist, or on the left side or on the right side, a button. Well, just use an icon, that's way cleaner. Then we can also redirect to cart. If they have added their product from the wishlist to their cart, they will be redirected automatically if you enable this option. I don't think that's very useful because where you have multiple items in your wishlist and you want to buy them all, they are just already redirected to your cart. So I would keep it off. Then you can also remove it from your wishlist when you're added to your cart. That would be logical. And you can also share your wishlist on social media with this option. If you enable this, you can choose on what social media. Share Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, email, WhatsApp. Well, I don't use Pinterest, but maybe your audience does. Or just show a share URL. Over here, we can change the text customization. The title of the wishlist. I'm going to remove the title as we don't want to have double titles on our wishlist. So this is way better. Add to cart, you can also change it to move to cart. Here we go. And then it's way more obvious because when you click this button, it will automatically move from the wishlist to the cart. But feel free to just use add to cart, whatever you want. Then we scroll down and we can also style and color customization it. Well, let me show you how it looks. Save options. And we can change the style of the add to cart button. Textual, button with theme style, button with custom style. I think it's the same as we've already seen, but let's check it out. My wishlist now, I have this product. I can remove it. There's the color, the price, the stock status. And we also have a move to cart button over here, which we cannot see right now. And then we have this one, move to cart, the beautiful purple from WooCommerce. And then the custom styles look like this, which I think is way better. So let's go over here, use the custom style and change this border radius to 5. And then you can see the move to cart button over here. And if I press it, it's been added to my cart successfully. Looks great. I like it. I like it a lot. Then when we go back to the options, you can also change the add to cart icon. Should it be a shopping cart or whatever you want? For example, you can choose a different kind of cart. On my website, I actually use the basket. So I'm going to use the shopping basket. These look great. Secondary buttons also look great. Then we have the table style. We could change the background, the text. Well, let's make the text a little bit darker. We have the borders and the highlight color. This is the gray color you saw over there. We can change it like this. And then we have also the share button. Text colors on hover and all the background styles of the buttons that we can see. These buttons over here. Well, they all look great now, so I'm just going to keep it like this. All right, I've shown you every single option of the wishlist. Let's add in some CSS to change the colors of the text. How to do this? Pretty easy. Just go to appearance and go to your customize over there. And then you just go over here to your product. And in here, we can see this, non-readable. Go to additional CSS. Now, what code to place in here? I have for you guys generated just a very simple CSS. You can go into the description of this video or in the comments, and I'll link to this TXT file. You just open this in Notepad, and then you just copy this. Here we go, copy. And then we go over here and just paste it in here. You can see three different things. The first one is this button, add to wishlist. The color is now 000, so you can change this to anything you want. For example, if you want to have green, you can just add in every kind of color you want in here from your own website. Then the second code, if I press add to wishlist, product added, then we have the second color, which is this one. You can change it to whatever color you want to have it. Remove from list. And then the third color over here is, of course, the view button. And you can change this also to any kind of color that you want to use in your theme. So we're just going to press on publish. And then on the wishlist itself, we can use only this color to change the product name. You might not encounter these problems as I encountered them because of your theme, but if you do, now you know how to customize it. Just copy all this and you can always change this the way you want. Press publish and our wishlist is almost completed. I also want to add in the link over here. And that's very easy. Just go back to your WordPress dashboard. Then we go over here to templates, go to the theme builder. And then we go to the header over here, click on edit. And then we're going to change this entire box to make it a link. And then the link will be /wishlist/view. If you put this link in there, it will always work also for not locked in users. And now we can go from anywhere on our website. We go over here to our wishlist. You can click on it. And there it is, our wish list, and we can view the products, remove them or move them to our cart or share this with other people. I can imagine you just want to see how I built this amazing e-commerce website. Just follow this tutorial over here and I'll walk you through it step by step in a 4 hours taking tutorial. It's gonna be great and I'll see you there.